Beauty Festival. My name is Samantha and I'm so happy to have you all here today, and what a fabulous day we've got lined up for you, featuring nutritional therapist and wellness guru Madeleine Shaw, who's going to help teach us how to create a delicious brunch bowl this morning. Then at 12:30 p.m. we have the wonderful Shannon from the virtual boutique team helping you discover your Clarins body's heroes. We've even got an exclusive makeup made for skin workshop with our very own Clarins beauty coach, Rebecca Jones, at 2 p.m. Then at 5:30, we're joined by Shannon and Georgia, who are going to share everything you need to know about how to feed your skin. And last, but certainly not least, we have the incredible Lorraine and Trish from Postcards from a Midlife podcast, recording a live podcast right here at the Clarins Virtual Beauty Festival. You won't want to miss it, and it's at 7 p.m. tonight. And most certainly and most importantly, please take note of our exclusive pre and promo code, which is Festival10. Add this to your checkout and receive £10 off when you spend £50. Terms and conditions apply. Don't forget, you do have a goodie bag. Get ready and share them with using the hashtag Clarins Beauty Festival on all of your social media channels. Enjoy the show.
Hello everyone, welcome to the Clarins Beauty Festival. I am the first person to kick off this festival, which I feel really honoured about. We've got a really exciting morning this morning. We're going to be making a breakfast bowl this morning. This could work for like breakfast, brunch, lunch, you can even have it for dinner if you want to. And this is my Green Goddess breakfast bowl. So this is something that inspired me to kind of use lots of really nice ingredients to freshen up your breakfast. I feel like breakfast is the best meal of the day. And this recipe is inspired by my time in Sydney. I went to university there and I was really inspired by the use of fresh ingredients and like that Aussie brunch style food. So hopefully we can whip this up together, whether you're cooking along with me or maybe you're just getting inspired to cook it later. So this recipe is also inspired by key ingredients that are in the plant-powered formula, the new Clarins Double Serum Eye. So there are four ingredients that we're drawing from. The first one is quinoa, like this. Or I used to call it quinoa. I don't know if anyone else did that. It's kind of one of those things where you read it and you think it's different. And then we've got chevril, wild chevril, but you can also use parsley as well. We've got the amazing spice turmeric that we're going to be using, and also my firm favorite, an avocado. So we've got some really great ingredients that are already in this serum that we're going to also cook with. So we're getting kind of that emulsion of these great ingredients through what we're eating, but also what we're putting on our skin, because I really believe that getting the glow and having that kind of glow that we all want is about not only what we put inside ourselves, but what we put on our skin as well. Okay, so don't forget that there's an amazing code, which is Festival10 in cap locks, and that gets you £10 off any £50 purchase, and that's at clarins.co.uk. So remember that, because that's always a really handy and great discount code. Okay, so let's get started. Let's get cooking. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to cook the quinoa. Quinoa is really, really simple to cook. All you need to do is one part quinoa to two parts water. So you can measure that in a mug, in a cup, or you can weigh out in scales. So we've got about 75 grams of quinoa that we're going to pop into our pot. We're going to pour over the water. And then we're going to add in turmeric. Okay, so quinoa I love. It's such a great grain. It's gluten-free and it's more considered a seed than a grain. Packed full of plant-based protein. And it's just really nice. Like, it works well in breakfast, it works well in lunch, it works in dinners. And what I like to do is just cook up a big batch of quinoa, have it in the fridge, and then you can add it into things throughout the week. And that makes life that little bit easier. Okay, so we're going to put in the turmeric. And that's going to give a really nice flavour to it, but also a fantastic colour. We're going to put a bit of salt in. Nice sea salt. And then we're going to cook that up on the hob, which is behind me. So to cook quinoa, you just bring it to a boil, you reduce it to a simmer, and then you let it cook for 12 minutes. So let's do that. Let's give that a nice stir to get that turmeric around. So we'll just wait for that to come to a boil, then we'll reduce it and we'll put our timer on for 12 minutes. Turmeric is a fantastic antioxidant, anti-inflammatory. It's a really good thing to be including in your diet if you exercise a lot and you need that like repair for your body. You know, and it's such a lovely flavour. I love using it in curries and stews. I have to say to you though, it's quite staining. So be careful on your hands. Don't wear white when you cook with quinoa. And not too much when you cook with turmeric, and also you know, your chopping boards in your hands and things like that, you're gonna have to give it quite a good scrub. So just so you know, I've got an iPad just down here where I can see your questions coming in. So if you've got any questions for me about the recipe, any kind of nutrition questions, cooking questions, beauty questions, please fire them to me because I can see them coming through and I can answer them for you. So we have got some delicious kale. Now this is a fantastic vegetable. So packed full of so many different vitamins. It's also relatively inexpensive and in season as well. So what we're doing is just ripping off the stems down the middle. They're a little bit too chewy, in my opinion, to eat. So you can rip them, but you can also cut them and just slice either side. And I like roasting kale, but I also like eating it raw, you know, massaging it like with olive oil and lemon juice and things like that to break it down is really nice raw. But we're going to roast it today in the oven. And what I like to do when I try and make a plate of food is aim to have around two portions of vegetables in it. I think that's a really good kind of aim for the day. You know, everyone talks about getting your five fruit and veg. And I definitely find it easy to kind of snack on fruit throughout the day. But if you're trying to put in like two portions of veg into your meals, it's a really good way of getting your quota up. And that's minimum too. You can add way more if you want to. Okay, right. So we've just cut off all the stalks here. So I'm just going to move something down. Got a beautiful Clarins candle lit. And I don't want to set myself on fire. That wouldn't be good. Okay, so we're using about 50 grams of kale leaves. I'm just going to roughly chop these up. We're going to be roasting them, so it doesn't matter, but you don't want them to be too big. So kind of aiming about this size. Okay, I've got some questions coming through. Could you use spinach instead of kale? You definitely can, but I wouldn't cook it in the same way because we're roasting in the oven and kale is a bit hardier, but you could definitely saute some spinach in a pan with some garlic and olive oil. That would be delicious. Or you could have it raw and literally just chuck it in. Absolutely. You know, it's not always about following the recipe exactly. You know, you can make it your own and also use what's in your fridge. You know, I really believe in not, you know, wasting food. So if you've got spinach, you've got rocket, you've got watercress, you can definitely use it. Just use it raw. Don't do the roasting bit. Okay, so we've got the kale on here. I've got this amazing olive oil. Oh my God, we're also using the same brand of honey as well. What a beautiful bottle this is. And we're just going to pour this olive oil over. I'm gonna give it a little massage. Okay. Can you eat kale raw, or do you always need to massage or cook it? Great question. So yeah, if I was making a raw kale salad, I'd add some lemon juice, some sort of acid, apple cider vinegar, massage it like this, and then could eat it quite happily. I mean, look, you can eat kale raw as it is. For me, it needs flavor. It needs different spices and things like that. Well, I really like it roasted, like making sort of like kale chips. But of course, you can eat it raw. But I think it's about making food bring joy to you. So if you don't like the taste of it raw, don't eat it because you think it's the only way to enjoy it. Cook it and enjoy it in the way that you really love to do, because then you're eating more of it, and that's kind of the key thing. Okay, so we've got a little bit oily hands. I'm just going to wash my hands here. Wash. Should have prepared a tea towel in advance. I thought I was very prepared, but there's always something missing, isn't there? Okay, we're just sprinkling over some salt. Okay, so question, what did you do before this was your job? This is a great question. What I'm going to do is I'm going to chuck this in the oven, and I'm going to come back to that question because I feel like it's quite a long story. So this is going in the oven for about 20 minutes, and let's just make sure that we've turned down that quinoa. Mine was definitely boiling for too long. And then just put on a timer, probably for about 10 minutes because it's probably been cooking. And I'll keep an eye on that as well. Okay, I'll be back in a sec. So basically, we're cooking the quinoa until it absorbs all the liquid, and we're roasting the kale in the oven until it gets nice and crispy. So those are the kind of like two things we're aiming for. About 10 minutes for the kale, but we're looking for it to be like a little bit crispy, and it's kind of not, we don't want it black or anything, but maybe a little bit bronze. Okay, so question was, what did I do before I did this job? So I'll talk you through what happened. So I moved to Australia when I was 18. I went to uni there. My family are from New Zealand, but was always obsessed with Australians. And while I was living over there, I discovered I had IBS and basically ended up sort of managing it through food and lifestyle. Got really interested in food and was basically ate at a cafe so much they gave me a job and ended up cooking. And that's where it all began. So it's been 9.5 years. Oh my God, a long time. So to be honest, this is really all I've ever done. But before that, my God, I did so many jobs. Dog walking. I worked in an investment bank for a period of time. Events. I did a lot of internships. I worked all throughout uni. Waitressing, for an interior designer for a year. But pretty much when I left uni and I moved back to London, which is where I'm from originally and live now today, I just knew I wanted to be in health and nutrition. And there wasn't really a career, like blogging and wellness wasn't a career, but I basically lived at home, did supper clubs, did talks, cooked for people, basically hustled in this area until it could support me and I could move out of home. So I've pretty much mainly done this, but I've done a lot of different jobs. I've been working since I was about 16. So I have done like a variety of different things, but my main career has always been this, which has been amazing. And I feel incredibly grateful for it. I was about to slice into an avocado, but let's put the eggs on. So we're going to soak all these eggs about 6.5 minutes. So you want to have a pan on with boiling water. I did prepare one in advance. Sorry, just getting all the hobs on. So get that big pan of water to boil. We're just going to boil 2 eggs for 6.5 minutes. So what you want to do is pop them onto a spoon like this and then lower them down into the cold water. I don't know about you, but I've definitely done those times where I just like chuck it in and then it just cracks and like explodes everywhere. So it really depends on you, how you like your eggs. It might be much softer and do like 6 minutes. It might be a little bit harder and you want to do 7 minutes, but I think 6.5 minutes is really good for me. And actually, I'm about to hit 6.5 minutes on my timer anyway, so it's all working out perfectly. Okay, beautiful. So we've got the eggs boiling, the kale roasting, the quinoa cooking, all taking shape, which is exactly what I want to see. And now we're going to make the dressing, and I'm going to answer more of your questions why I do that. Okay, so do you need to stir the quinoa or just leave it cooking? Just leave it cooking. You don't need to stir it. Keep that lid on. Just make sure it's on a simmer, not on a boil, so it's just bubbling away rather than like it's really, really hot. So you probably want to keep it on quite a low heat. Okay, so what is your favourite feel-good food? Ooh, great question. Favourite feel-good food would be something warm and comforting, like a sweet potato, like Thai laksa, or I've been making like a lentil shepherd's pie recently. That's sort of like really like comforting food. I'm really enjoying, especially because it's getting colder. But also I love coconuts, like Thai fresh coconuts. They're quite hard to source, but my God, are they, like when I drink it, I feel like it's the elixir of life. I like come back, I regenerate from it. So I really, really enjoy that. And then what temperature is the oven for the kale? Sorry, I didn't say it. That's 180 for the kale in the oven for 10 minutes. Where did you live in Sydney? I'm from Bondi. Amazing. Well, I worked in Bondi Junction, but I lived in Rushcutters Bay for 2 years. Sorry, this is really irrelevant for people who don't go to Sydney. And then the first year I moved around, so I was like Rose Bay, Double Bay, mainly eastern suburbs. But I think if I was to move back, I'd live in Avalon. In the northern beaches, like up the top. That's my future home, I think. Okay, guys, let's make the dressing. So we've got some fantastic ingredients going in here. We've got avocado. My aunt from New Zealand used to have an avocado farm, and I have been eating avocados since I was a baby, and just love them and eat them mainly whole, you know, as normal. But this is a really great dressing where we blend avocados and we kind of use its really lovely sort of texture. And what I love about this dressing is if you've got an avocado that's maybe a little bit brown, this is great. You can still use it because we're not necessarily using it for the color, we're using it for the texture and also the healthy fats. One of my like key things I say to people when they are thinking about what to eat for good skin is healthy fats. So your avocados, your nuts, your seeds, your olive oils, these are just so good for having healthy skin. And I know that when I got my head out of that thing of like, fat is bad for us, fat's going to make us fat, and really embraced them, my hair started growing, my skin started looking so much plumper and nicer. So I know how much it makes a difference on myself, but also on others as well. Okay, so we've got avocado going in, we've got yogurt, you can use coconut or natural yogurt going in there. So that's one whole avocado. And I think I wrote it down, to get up my ingredients, 50 grams of Greek yogurt. We're gonna put in some honey, a tablespoon of honey, again, beautiful. Delicious honey. So this is a flower infused honey. I love honey so much. I think honey, Greek yogurt and honey has to go down as like one of my favorite desserts. So simple, so easy to make, and just like hits the spot. Let's get in there. So that's just gonna sweeten the dressing. The honey is also a really antibacterial, antiviral, so if you're feeling a little bit coldy, it's such a great ingredient to have in the diet. We're also going to be adding in some lemon juice. I'm just going to slice in half. I'm just going to squeeze it through my fingers to make sure none of the seeds go in. Okay, so if you don't have a blender, could you use a pestle and mortar for this dressing? Probably not, I'm sorry. Pestle mortaring an avocado. Give it a go. I would almost just chop it, like chop up the avocado and then mix it together. Do you know what? You definitely could. As long as you minced all the ingredients before, you could do it. I'd like to see your recreation. Definitely tag Clarins and me in your recreations when you make this recipe. If you're making it right now or you make it later, I would love to see that. This is such a great little blender. It's really handy because it doesn't have a lead, so you can move it around. And I adore that. I use it all the time for dressings. Okay, could you use an avocado alternative? I don't know if anything's gonna like. I don't think anything is going to be able to replace it, but I would just omit it. So you just take it out, maybe add a bit more a bit more yogurt, a bit more herbs. But I don't know if there's something that you could do. Maybe courgette, a raw courgette. But I would just almost take it out rather than swap it. Okay, so we've got spring onion going in, just one whole spring onion, garlic, just take the skin off, whack it in there. And we've got some really nice fresh herbs here. I love having herbs. What I'll do is I'll just keep this in the fridge like that, such a bit of water in the bottom, and that keeps it for longer. So we're doing about 2 tablespoons of chopped mint and 2 tablespoons of chopped chevril or parsley, flat leaf parsley. I'm not a curly leaf parsley fan. I don't know what everyone else thinks, but it just doesn't do it for me. I've got to be flat all the way. Okay, right, a bit more mint. Oh, that's my timer. Just saying, check on everything. I've got so much tech going on. I've got like a phone, a laptop, an iPad. Ooh, all kicking off here. Okay, so let's get these eggs on. Down by the dressing. I just turned the curl off as well. I've just left it there. So let's finish this dressing before I get too distracted. Okay, so chevril or parsley, again, 2 tablespoons of that. That is going to be our dressing. Whack that in there. Bit of salt, bit of pepper. Good. And lid. Okay, we've got loads more questions. I'm vegan, is that alternative? I would swap out for the Greek yogurt and honey. So yeah, coconut yogurt for the Greek yogurt, and then you can swap honey for maple, or probably maple syrup or brown rice syrup or something like that could work really well. Okay. You want to blend it so it's nice and smooth, and then give it a little taste, always important. Yum. Now, it depends what kind of consistency you like. What I tend to do is just add water for the consistency instead of like oil, which I think is quite common. I think you think that water is gonna take away the flavor, but it doesn't, as long as you only add it in small increments until you get it to the consistency that you like. I'm just gonna add a little bit in because I want it a bit thinner. So I'm probably putting in about a tablespoon or two. Okay, so someone's asked, can you use the dressing on a salad or anything else? Absolutely, this Green Goddess dressing, we're not gonna use all of it on the breakfast dish. You can use this as a dip. You can add this to different grains. You can add this, spread it on toast, sprinkle over some seeds, delicious. This, you know, I really like to make maybe 2-3 dressings, whether it's this, harissa, pesto, chimichurri, and have them in the fridge and just add them to different dishes and just bring them to life. Miso is another favorite of mine. Hold on. A little bit more water, maybe another. Okay, beautiful. So I've kept it quite thick because I quite like that thick texture, but yeah, it's like this. So I don't know. Okay, can you use the dressing on anything else? I've answered that one. Some olive oils are so expensive. Does it really make a difference? Annoyingly, yes. A lot of oils, they can misprint them and they can put like a blend of vegetable oil with the olive oil and still call it olive oil. So always read the back. Look for 100% olive oil. Cold press, ideally. Extra virgin, ideally. What I tend to do is cook with olive oil that's not extra virgin and then use extra virgin more in salad dressings because that often tends to be more expensive. Other oils that I like to use are like macadamia nut oil for the old Bondi gal or guy. Listening, you'll love some macadamias. But macadamia nut oil, I love, and avocado oil, other great oils to cook with, or ghee or butter. These are all, you know, slightly less expensive ones that you can use. But I do think quality is important. But you're right, olive oil can be crazily expensive. But I think if you buy in bulk, buy those big ones, you know, the big like tin ones, that can help reduce the price. And then just look on the back and look just so it's 100% olive oil, not mixed with other oils. That's a key thing to look out for. Okay, do you think your diet plays a role in how your skin looks? Definitely. I'm just going to peel the eggs, by the way, while I keep answering these questions. Yeah, absolutely. I think that, you know, when I, especially when I was younger and I wasn't eating very well, and I'm just going to run this under cold water for a second. I remember, like, when I started eating well and looking after myself, just how many people came up to me and said, "Oh, you look so different, you look so healthy." And that's where I kind of coined the term glow and get the glow, which was what my first book was called and my first little talks in London called. But yeah, I think that it makes such a difference. So the kind of key things that I recommend for healthy skin are lots of healthy fats. So that's from your nuts and seeds, your avocado, you know, oily fish like mackerel, sardines, salmon. I know lots of people don't eat fish, but you can get those omega-3s from flax seeds, from chia seeds, from walnuts as well. So don't fear if you don't eat fish. But those are really included to be in your diet every day, because remember, omega-3 is an essential fatty acid. And that means it is essential for your body. So your body needs it. And I think most of us are deficient in it. So supplementing with either a fish oil or a vegan alternative. There's lots of great vegan fish or omega-3, sorry, not fish. Vegan versions out there, which are fantastic. So you could definitely use them. And then I think also other lifestyle things, like getting a good night's sleep, makes such a difference, and reducing stress. So trying things like meditation, you know, reading before you go to bed rather than scrolling through your phone, having, you know, technology breaks. I think that technology and social media is amazing, but also it can spiral us into comparing ourselves to others, not feeling like we're enough, good enough, doing enough. So I think having social media breaks and you know, going and being in nature, just immersing yourself in like a forest or a beach, is really good. Okay, when did your love for food begin? Oh, that's such a nice question. I always loved cooking cakes growing up. Like, I was that, I don't know, we grew up in a family where, like, if it was your birthday, you had to have a homemade cake. So I'd always make cakes for like friends' birthdays. So I kind of was into like baking. And if there's any Kiwis listening, it was the Edmonds cookbook that like I basically got everything from, which is like an institutional cookbook. I feel like we only had that cookbook and we basically only cooked for that. So that was like my introduction to food, is the Edmonds cookbook. And then what else? And then, yeah, I guess it was living in Australia and just the way that they ate brunch. And, you know, I remember like going to a pub and like ordering this tuna salad, and it was like this amazing fresh like lettuce with like the most beautifully cooked like tuna that was like seared and raw in the middle. And I remember thinking like, what would the equivalent be at a pub in London? And I know that this is 12 years ago, by the way, things have changed, but I was really inspired by the use of like fresh ingredients. But yeah, I guess my passion and love for food has just like grown as I've grown as a person into like what I like cooking, and then obviously learning more about nutrition and understanding that link, and then wanting to cook with nutritious food, but also making it delicious. But yeah, the passion is still there, which is good, because that would be really rubbish if that stopped, because you have to eat and you can't really let that passion go. So I'm glad I still like cooking and food. Okay, which foods do you have in your fridge? How do you keep them fresh? What a fantastic question. Okay, guys, while I answer your questions, I'm just going to start placing up. So I'm going to basically grab a bowl and I'm going to grab all the ingredients. I'll be back in one sec and I will answer your question. So here is the kale, talking of greens, looking nice and crispy. Let's give it a try. So good. Sometimes, God, I really salted them. Salty. I make these for my son. I was like, crisp alternatives. He's kind of like game, but when he then tries like a proper crisp, he definitely prefers them. That's not to say that he's perfect in any way, but they're quite good for crisp alternatives. Really delicious. I also make like beetroot crisps as well, which are really good. Okay, so we've got the lovely cooked quinoa, looking, smelling delicious with all that turmeric in there. I just love that colour and that flavour as well. So I'm going to just start placing that. While I do it, I will answer that question. Hold on, my iPad's gone down. So it was, what greens do I have? So it really varies. I always try and have some leafy greens, whether that's the spinach, kale, rocket, watercress. But then I always probably buy courgettes every week, just because I love slicing them up, roasting them with lemon zest, fresh mint, olive oil. But then I like microgreens. I don't know if anyone else has eaten them, but they're like really small, and they have them in loads of different like broccoli, micro coriander, all different stuff, but they're really potent. So if you're someone that doesn't like eating a lot of green vegetables, go for microgreens, because you get the like bulk of like the nutrition of eating like this much salad in like a really minute version. So it's almost like a supplement. So I really recommend microgreens, really delicious and small. What is the one ingredient you always have in your kitchen cupboard? Can of chickpeas, I think. Just love them. So great to roast, put in tray bakes, add to salads, mix them through dressings. Yeah, just love it. Okay, so I'm just putting quinoa on half the plate. I made quite a lot, so I've got extras for later. I'm going to pop that crispy kale on the other half. Looking so good. I'm so excited. It's quite late for breakfast. I normally do have breakfast, but I was like, I'm going to wait because I know I'm going to really, really enjoy this. I don't know if anyone else has done the same. Okay, so we've got little eggies. We're going to pop on top. And then we've got the lovely dressing and some almonds as well. Okay, question says, how do you relax? how do I relax? I read a lot. So I always read for like 40 minutes before bed. That's a really lovely way for me to switch off, and I enjoy getting lost in books and go through books quite quickly. And I love watching TV. And I love being in nature. I always try and do like a big hour and a half walk a few times a week in a forest nearby, which I love. I love swimming in the ocean, although I don't do that very often, but that for me, I'm going on holiday next week, is very special. And how else do I relax? Meditation and just breathing. Something that I can share with you, which is really helpful, is called the 40-second check-in. So we can all do it right now together, and then we will eat, I promise. And if you just close your eyes, put your hand on your heart, and you just do a body scan. So you just focus on the top of your head, move down through your eyes, relax your jaw, your neck, relax your chest, your belly, relax your arms, your legs, your feet. And then just ask yourself these questions. What do I need right now? And let whatever comes up, come up. It might be a glass of water, a deep breath, call a friend, eat this delicious food. But this is a really nice question to tune into yourself every day, two times a day. But I think often we don't tune in and know what we need in that moment. And I recommend this 40-second check-in just to recenter and connect and tune in with our bodies. We're always in our heads, planning, thinking. But I think what meditation, what yoga, what a lot of these great practices do is connect you with your body. And your body can tell you a lot more about what's going on and what you need in that moment. So I hope that has helped you for you. Okay, so dressing is going on. We're just going to do a nice little drizzle all over. But look, I've got heaps left. That will last like maybe 3-4 days in the fridge. So yeah, on toast, on different salads. You know, you could even like marinate tofu or chicken in that and bake it. It's versatile. Okay, what is your favorite sweet treat? So I'm gonna sprinkle some almonds on the top again. My favorite sweet treat. Ooh. Okay, so I talked to you about honey and yogurt. That's a fave. And then tarte citron. You know, the like French lemon curd tarts. Anything kind of French patisserie. So I love pain au chocolat, pain au raisin, croissants. I don't know what they're called. They're like, you know, if you go to like a French patisserie and they're like this pastry and they go like swirl around like this. I don't know what it is. It's basically like pastry and sugar in a like heart-shaped swirl. Whatever that is, it's fantastic. So yeah, chocolate I do really love as well. But yeah, basically give me like a French patisserie and I'll be very happy. Which vinegar do you prefer in salad dressing, apple cider or balsamic? Great question. I actually like both. I love a kind of grainy mustard, balsamic olive oil dressing, but then I also do love a sort of apple cider vinegar, honey or garlic dressing as well. So I kind of change it up. I think I find balsamic a little bit heavier, so that goes with certain things, and I find apple cider vinegar a bit crisper and lighter, so it depends what kind of salad vibe I'm going for. Is there extra quinoa on top left over? What else can I use this for? Yeah, I've got loads of extra quinoa left over. I did make quite a lot more than the recipe because I wanted some extra for myself. Just mix this in with like roasted vegetables. You can put it as a side like this, because it's got turmeric, it could go really well with like a curry. So if you're making like a veggie curry, you could use that instead of rice. You can even like make this into patties, so put some like eggs and flour and roll up and make quinoa patties or quinoa burgers. You can, what else can you do with this? Yeah, you can almost blend it and make it into little quinoa pancakes. So blend it with a little bit of milk and then fry them into like little quinoa pancakes, savory ones. Yeah, lots. Okay, da-da-da-da. Here's the beautiful dish. I'm gonna try it. I don't know if anyone else cooked it along with me and is digging in right now as well. I'd love to know. There we go. Okay, next question. Can I make this in a brunch or meal prep for later in the week? Absolutely. You could wrap that in the fridge with a lid on. You could eat it maybe a day, 2 days time. Absolutely, it's a great food prep recipe. What are your passions outside of cooking? What am I passionate about? I'm really passionate about walking. I love walking and going on hikes and being in nature. I'm really passionate about growth. So I love self-development, growing, learning more, expanding my mind, whether that's through courses, books, online. I'm really passionate about the planet, learning more of different things I can do to be more sustainable. I'm really passionate about interiors. I love like homeware and beautiful furniture. And I'm really passionate about my family, a little boy, and I love him very much. And I'm really passionate, sorry, this list is going on. I'm just trying to think what else I'm passionate about. I'm passionate about a lot of things. I'm passionate about life. I do enjoy life. Okay, what's your favorite ingredient to promote glowing skin? That's hard, one ingredient. Probably omega-3 rich food. I know that's got many ingredients, but like your mackerel, your flax seeds, your walnuts. Also collagen powder is something that a lot of people rave about and I have used and seen some great results from as well. But I think it's got to be in balance with a good night's sleep, reducing stress, hormones is really important, balanced hormones and good skincare. You know, just, it's so hard, isn't it, being a modern day woman. We have to just like balance and do so many things. But hopefully they bring us all joy, like cooking and looking after ourselves. Okay, what's on the menu for dinner tonight? I haven't planned it. I'm a little bit of a last minute with, I'm really good at organizing the first few days. So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, always planned out. But when it comes to Friday, we've been cooking a lot of mussels recently. So going to the fishmonger, scrubbing them off, making them with like a tomato broth, some nice olive bread, salad. That's been like a go-to recently. I do this kind of like chickpea cod tomato stew or like a pumpkin soup. Maybe one of those three. I haven't quite decided. I actually need to probably tidy the kitchen before we get into that. okay, I think I've answered all the questions now. Yes, I'm up to date, which is fantastic. So let me know if anyone is digging in, trying it. And of course, don't forget about the code. You get £10 off any £50 purchase, and that's at clarins.co.uk. And show the beautiful serums that we've got here. I've been using this one, which is the one that's got these four fantastic ingredients, the chèvre, the quinoa, where are all the other ones? Turmeric is here, and the avocado, which is already in the dressing. That's just really good. I've always like found like eye serums just so relaxing to put on. I always do like a little massage. So, what I tend to do, because I don't know about you, but I store a lot of tension in my eyebrows, so I'll put it on. I don't know if this is the right application. Clarins, you can tell me if I'm doing it right. But I kind of sweep out and then I sweep up and I push a bit of pressure into my eyebrows and then lift up. I don't know. I got told it's because I'm an overthinker that I store a lot of tension in my eyebrows, but often like here, I sort of push pressure and then move it out. And that instantly makes me feel more relaxed. And I feel like that's like a little ritual that I'll do with the eye cream, like a bit of massage, a bit of pushing out. I'm just seeing if there's any other. Oh, I'm not a fan of turmeric. Sorry, I haven't finished all the questions. Is there anything else I can use? I can totally see why you don't like it. For the quinoa, I just cook it plain with some salt and pepper. What other spice could work quite nicely instead? Maybe smoked paprika would be nice, or some garlic. But you could cook it without the turmeric, by the way. It's not an essential. It's really just there for colour and a little bit of flavour. It's not super potent or powerful. I just think it looks really pretty, that sort of pop of colour. And I've got that tri-colour quinoa where some of the colours haven't taken on. But if you've got just plain white quinoa, it will probably pop even more. A kitchen gadget I couldn't live without. Definitely this little blender, because I use it for a lot of salad dressing. So this is KitchenAid cordless small blender, small food processor, something like that. What else? I love a spatula. I like to reduce food waste, so really scraping every bit of sauce off. You know, like, I'll definitely scrape this out. I don't want to waste any of it. And a good sharp knife, a good chopping board. Okay, you said one, didn't you? You wanted just one kitchen gadget. Let's just go with this. I really appreciate all of you coming out today. I'm not sure exactly what time I have to wrap up. But yeah, I just really appreciate everyone coming out today and, you know, cooking with me and learning with me. And yeah, I really had a good time. So yeah, if you've got any more questions, knock yourself out, but I just need to quickly check something. Just scrolling up. What is your favourite of all your cookbooks? That's a great question. So for those who don't know, I've got three cookbooks. First one's Get the Glow, second one is Ready, Steady, Glow, and the third one's A Year of Beautiful Eating. I feel like probably my first one, just because I never imagined I would write a cookbook. I remember when my manager said to me, would you like to write a cookbook? And I was like, no, that's what Jamie Oliver does. That's what I'm going to do. You know, I really would have never expected it in my life, like, hands down. But I just think, yeah, just the faith that people put in me, the great response and reviews, like, oh, I'll never forget that. So yeah, it's got to be my first one, just because it was the beginning. It was the beginning of this very exciting adventure that I've been, like, cruising along, rolling with. Okay, what is it? What's next? Okay, favorite meal of the day, breakfast, lunch, or dinner? It's so, I feel like it really depends on where I am. I feel like if I'm on holiday, I do love a lunch that's like, you know, you've been at the beach all day and then you like sit down and have like this amazing lunch. But then I do love breakfast at home, you know, on Saturday when you have to rush and you make pancakes with your family and that sort of, I don't know, I think it really depends on like where I am. But right now I'm at home. So let's say breakfast, Saturday breakfast, where like you're not rushing out the door, you're not doing a school run, and you just have that like endless time to cook and plan out the fun, the rest of your day and like the fun that you're gonna have. So yeah, that's gonna be it for me. Can I use a substitute the eggs for tofu? Absolutely, that'd be really nice. A little bit of crispy tofu in the pan. Yeah, I think that would work really, really well and be a really nice kind of swap, so you've still got some protein in the dish. Although quinoa does also have protein, it's a good plant-based protein in there. But yes, absolutely, some crispy tofu would be really nice. And you just do that by sprinkling maybe, you could use the turmeric, garlic and ginger, a bit of oil, fry it in the pan until it's nice and crispy. I think that'd be delicious. Great, great idea. Okay, you have great skin. What is your secret? Thank you very much. It's very kind. I guess it's pretty much what I've been saying to you. If you go on my Instagram, Madeleine_Shaw_, I just did a little reel about five things that I do for better skin. But drinking lots of water, really key. There's no water bottle. You just reminded me that I need to drink some more. Getting a good night's sleep, managing your stress, eating lots of healthy fats. I think also, you know, not just healthy fats, but like lots and lots of green leafy vegetables, lots of antioxidant rich foods like berries, dark leafy greens, these even dark chocolate as well. These are all really, really good for your skin to have lots of antioxidants in them as a sort of internal sunscreen and protection for kind of damage as well. So that's also a really good thing to do. And then also have a really good skincare routine. So making sure that you're cleansing, you're using your serums and you're protecting your skin. I always wear SPF and I have for many years, and I think that's made such a difference of every day I put SPF on to protect my skin. Even in winter as well. And that, I think, makes a big difference that you're sort of like reducing damage to your skin. Using an eye serum, of course, or serum eye. That I think is really important for reducing that kind of puffiness, but also brightening up your eye area as well. What else do I do for good skin? Oh, I do a lot of massage as well, like using the gosha. I never know if I'm pronouncing it right. I always feel a bit self-conscious. Even just with your fingers, you know, moving up and out and doing that sort of lymphatic drainage. There's lots of great videos, but I found, you know, I was starting to get some lines on my forehead, and just doing that sort of massage and movement has made a big difference. And also drinking lots of water as well, because often those are dehydration lines, but also, let's be honest, they're also just from like using your face. Okay, last question we've got is, what's one piece of life advice you would say to your 20-year-old self? Oh my god, what a great question. What a great final question to leave. Okay, so when I was 20, what was I going through? I think I was really questioning where my life was going at 20 and really wanted to have it all figured out. So I'd probably say to myself, you don't have to have it all figured out at 20. Embrace the body and person that you have now and not wish it to be something else. And I would say, yeah, enjoy that freedom, you know, when you're 20, that you're not worried about paying the mortgage or bills or your job. You know, you're in this sort of free moment. So I'd probably say, worry less, be free, embrace who you are and look after yourself. And I'll probably be telling myself that when I'm in my 40s about now being in my 30s. I probably will have the same advice each year, just less stress, less worry. But I actually don't think I would want to be 20 again. I am really enjoying being in a new decade. And yeah, I think I feel more sure of myself and more happier within myself than I did when I was 20. So that's a good thing. Thank you guys all so much. Just a final reminder of the code FESTIVAL10, that's festival in capital letters and then the number 10, 10, for £10 off any £50 purchase at clarins.co.uk. I have been your first, I'm sure, of many exciting things that are coming today. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the festival. I know it's going to be fantastic. I'm going to be tuning in, getting all the tips, but I really hope that you have enjoyed the beginning of this fantastic event with me. I've really appreciated you coming out, and hopefully you have cooked this up or you've inspired to cook this recipe again. And yeah, it's a great recipe, really simple and easy, so nutritious. Thank you so much. Bye. Just eat the food now, basically.